This is Anthony from Texas Blues Alley. It's time for Free Lesson Friday. This week, going to make some of you old-timers happy. We're digging into the ZZ Top back catalog, and we're taking a look at Waitin For The Bus. Now, if you're a youngin' like me, if I can use that word, your introduction to ZZ Top was probably some of their later stuff. And you may have just kind of assumed that that's what all ZZ Top music sounds like, but that is not the case, my friend. If you dig into some of their earlier material, you will find a much more stripped down, I don't think organic is the right word, but it's a very more raw sound than maybe some of their later, more produced stuff. Both are great, but if you want to hear how ZZ Top started, I encourage you to go back and dig into some of those older albums. This one comes from the Tres Hombres album. I'm probably saying that wrong, but I think that came out in 1973. So if you can imagine all of the awful music that came out in the 70s, imagine this being part of that. You know, there was good stuff happening even during that awful decade. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to demonstrate the whole 12-bar progression, and then we'll go through a breakdown. I'll teach it to you note for note, and then on the album, it kind of sounds like he's got a double track thing going on, two guitars, gives you a little bit of a wider sound. I'm going to show you how to kind of simulate that a little bit by adding in some droning notes if you happen to be the only guitarist in the band and you got to kind of try and get that sound. Now, if you're a member of the TXBA Locals program, you are going to get Sound Slice Tablature with this over in the Locals section. Just find that in the Explore tab and then load it up and you'll see the tablature there. And you'll get this little jam track that you can practice along with looping and slow motion and all of that other good stuff. Let's get into the demo and then the breakdown. All right, first things first, we're in the key of A, and we're in standard tuning. We're going to be doing a lot of stuff right around here at the fifth fret. So the whole premise of this whole thing is this little lick right here. We're basically going to be doing that over the one and the four. So the basically between seven and five on the D string. So it's back and forth. And then two hits there. And as long as we're on the one chord, we're going to jump up and do two hits on the fifth fret of the G string before we start the whole thing over again. Now, a couple of style things to give it the right sound. On the first slide, you kind of want to slide into that note and you want to put heavy vibrato on it. And then everything after that, you want to be short and punchy. Okay? And on those two bends there, especially on the second one, give it a little bend like that before you come down. And you can't really slide into it after that first one, but you really want to emphasize that first note of the lick and let it ring out. So you might be wondering, how do you get that punchy sound for the other notes? Well, that's where the fat side of your picking hand comes in. You just kind of rest that a little bit past the bridge here. Close to the bridge, clamp it down, and that allows the note to ring out, but not to be too ringy. Also, some of that comes into how fast you lift off the strings after you've played it. So if you really hammer that note hard with vibrato, Let it ring out. It creates a nice little contrast between those things. So basically, you're going to do that four times for the four bars from 1 to 4. Now, right before you would start it for the fifth time, you'll end on this. You're going to slide up to the root of the four chord here, the 10th fret, and you're going to go right to the 12. The same relative spot if we move that whole box up here. Going to play the same pattern. The only difference is now, instead of, we're going to go. So instead of two hits here, two hits there and back, it's two hits back to 10, up to there, up to 10 on the G string, and then back down. Do that twice, and right before you would start it the third time, end there, back to the one, and back to our, that pattern again. Do that twice, and before you would start it the third time, now we're at bar number 9, and we're going to play some chords, kind of the end of the 12-bar progression. The first one, we're essentially going to be forming this 7th chord over the E, which would be the 5 chord in the key of A. So what you play is, low E string open, bend at the 3rd fret of the low E, and then have you want to do this with your ring finger. Open, bend with your ring finger up like that, hit the 2nd fret, which is the octave up from the root down here, at the 2nd fret of the D string, and then you want to fret the 3rd fret of the B string with your pinky, and the 1st fret of the G string with your ring finger. So you want to have those all ready. You kind of have this chord fretted, and then reach down here. So that's your timing. Then we're going to play a little bit of a weird chord. We're going to go up here, which would essentially be the 6. Instead of dropping to the 4, so we played here. That's what it would be if it were a 12-bar progression, but instead they go from the 5 up to the root of the 6. So 2nd fret of the low E string, octave up, 4th fret of the D string, and then 1st fret of the B string, 2nd fret of the G string. So just put those two together. And then a real quick ending. 5 to 2 on the D string, 3rd fret of the A string, open. And it goes right back into that pattern. So that the two repeats of that pattern after our little chord thing. Two more of those will take us to the end of the 12 bars. So let's do a quick review. 4 of this pattern over the 1. Right before we start the 5th one, slide up here to the 4 chord. Modify our pattern a little bit. Before we start with the 3rd one there, we slide back to the 1. 2 more. Play our little chords. Alright, so that is our core pattern, what we're doing there. Now, if you listen on the album, it sounds a little bit fatter than what I'm doing here, and that's because this rhythm is double tracked on the album, meaning that he recorded it once, then he recorded it again. Sometimes they're doing the exact same things. Sometimes, like I taught you how to go, sometimes he's doing that with the one guitar and with the other. So it creates a much fatter sound. So what can we do if we're the only guitarist in the band who's playing this? Well, one of the things that you can do to get the sound of two guitars playing this first note is to let this low A string ring out as you play this first note of the pattern. And let that drone while you do this back and forth. All right, so that creates a little bit of a fatter sound. The other thing you can do is instead of a single note here, just fret the note below it as well. Or just fret it on the first one. Now, that's all fine and good, but what happens if you slide up here to the four? How do you get that sound? Well, the simple answer is just put your thumb over the low E string and play the octave there. All right, so if you want to get a little bit more extreme, you can actually play the low A string open, fret the low E string at the fifth fret here, and that note all together. So you're playing three of the exact same pitch. All right, so that gets a little bit extreme, but you see what I'm going for there. We're adding droning notes to kind of mimic the sound of having two different guitars playing together, which is what he had on the album. So there you have it. That's how you play the rhythm part to Waitin For The Bus by ZZ Top. I hope you go into their back catalog and find some of this old stuff because it's really, really great. Just a fantastic band. And it's a real testament to what you can do with just a trio. It's so kind of easy to make a big sound when you've got keyboards and horns and stuff like that. But some of that stuff where it's just their real stripped-down trio sound is really fantastic. It's something to strive towards, I think. So I hope you enjoy this lesson, and until next time, thanks for watching.